Hi YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and it's February 20th and just a gorgeous day. There is not a cloud in the sky, not even a chemtrail. it's got to be close to 60. I have shed my barn coat. I'm in long sleeves. It's fleece, but that's not too bad for February in Michigan. And we're all out here working in the barn. Well, Charlotte's not, but that's normal. But Laina and I are in the midst of trying to clean up the barn because midwinter it just gets horrendous out here with loose hay and just stuff everywhere. And of course it looks that way now because we haven't put it back together, but we're cleaning up the floor. And then Laina really worked hard in her rabbit tree. We're going to do some rabbit grooming and rabbit weighing. Our first show is first weekend in March, the 5th and the 6th, and that'll be at MSU, Michigan State University. If anybody in Michigan is going to be there, look us up. We'll be there with our Laina's American Fuzzy Labs. It's a two-day show, and there's three shows. But we've got to demat the bunnies and weigh the bunnies and see if we have 2 weeks to see if anyone has to be force-fed or on a starvation diet. No, we won't do that to the bunnies, but you have to have them a certain weight. And so we'll see how everybody is according to their age and gender, and go from there. We are anxious. This day is just a teaser. It makes you so anxious for spring. She's gonna get her scale down, her baby scale, and then Tim has been busy. Here, take a look. He's back here working on the horse stall. He's gonna try to do the pig pen, the outdoor pig pen, so he could bring the pigs up, but the ground is still frozen. It might be warm and it might seem like spring, but 4 inches down and it's still pretty frozen. And the paddock is a mucky, muddy mess, like it always is this time of year. Yeah, you think so too, huh, Coda? Right on cue. So, pretty soon though, we'll have a horse stall. Looking good. You finding anything else wrong?
No.
Okay. Do I dare ask? It's a loaded topic. Oh, you got your first victim?
3 1/4. He's good weight.
3 1/4. He's a
junior.
He's a junior buck.
He'd be a junior buck.
This is Cloud. That's a good weight. Tell me again his color. I never can
remember. Siamese Sable Point, I think.
Siamese Sable Point. Is that what his papers say?
I'd have to look.
Okay. So write him down so he can go.
Yes, you can go.
His coat's pretty good, too.
He needs to be groomed, though.
Well, but I don't feel a lot of mats.
No, there's not a lot of mats on.
Okay.
Okay, there's one mat.
Next. I hope our scale is accurate.
It is. I checked it.
All right.
Oh, you need to stop. You are not the funniest rabbit I own.
So that's a Saturday in February in Michigan. A beautiful Saturday. The bunnies over here are enjoying the sunshine. The old man's just sitting here sleeping. And the old woman, she's eating. I know, I said I was going to do these guys in. Because they're our ancient meat rabbits. The first two I started with, well, and I haven't done it yet. But we are short on cages, so they are old. He's really looking old. He's blowing his coat right now. And there's Will.
Out of the rabbit tree. Nope. I don't have my broom to chase him out with.
Yeah, he's ducking behind there. She broke her broom.
I did not break it. It was breaking already.
Well, there, he's out. There he went.
Out. Oh, I almost caught him.
Yep. You can't catch Will. He's Will Ferrell. He's feral.
This is Wish.
Three and a half, she's perfect. She is just graduated to senior doe. This will be her first show as a senior doe.
I gotta write that down.
And everybody tells us that they don't do well when they're just transitioning, but we're gonna take her anyway. What the hey? Been driving all that way down state and getting a hotel. Why not?
Yeah, I'll take her. Yeah. And she's one of my better
dogs. She's got a beautiful hair coat.
It's so plush and good. It's not super soft, but it's soft.
Yeah.
Come here, baby.
Oh, don't squash the bunnies.
That's the way I pick them
out. Next. This is our vintage baby scale. Like I say, I hope it's accurate.
Here you go. It is.
I already weighed a pound, a thing of butter, so.
Well, you should do like a 5-pound bag of sugar or flour, or a 10-pound bag of flour.
I know it was 4 pounds of sugar.
Okay, well, it's good.
It's pretty accurate.
Yeah, that's a good way to test an old scale. Alright, welcome back. This is our senior buck ranger. He's the dad.
Hold still and I can actually read it.
Of most of our bucks.
A little over...
He's just under 4 pounds. I can see it.
Yeah,
from here.
He's a little over, he's about three, a little over 3.5.
Well, that's just right.
Mm-hmm.
Is he skinny though?
No.
Oh no, he's nice.
Good boy. His smut's gone away.
Yep. The one thing we don't like about Ranger is he has, when he gets nervous, one ear goes up. You see this ear? and one of his daughters does the same thing. But he does pretty well, even with his funny ear. Oh no, we can't. So Ranger's got.
He's over 4 pounds.
This is Gigi.
We can't take her. She's over 4 pounds.
Well, we can cut her back for the next 2 weeks, see
no,
if we can get her there.
No, she's too much over 4 pounds. She's way too much over.
Oh, she's.
But she's not thin. Or no, she's not fat.
Wait, quit petting her. Let me just see. She's just a hair. She's 4 1/4. She's a 1/4 pound over. We can get a 1/4 pound off this bunny.
But I don't want her to be hungry.
She won't be hungry. We'll put her on Atkins. It'll be fine. You can have all the meat you want.
We are not feeding her meat.
No, she has just a gorgeous coat.
Margaret's rabbit, that's why. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this one breeder. Anyway, she's a senior doe. So
yep.
I think we can, if we'll check her before, if we can get her there. She's only 1/4. If it was a pound or something, I'd say no.
Like Brie?
Shh. Don't talk about Brie. Poor
Brie.
There
you go, big girl.
All right.
Well, do we want
to
weigh Hocus?
No, that'll just be embarrassing. All right, we'll bring Hocus out just to show the difference between... between a brood doe...
Here.
She's our crazy bunny.
I need a step stool.
You are too short.
Yeah.
She's what you call a brood doe. She will never make it on the show table because she's just a big doe. But she throws better than herself, and she throws big litters.
Don't bite me either,
because
I don't
want to
be bit.
But we got her as an adult. She had obviously had not been handled, and she's still kind of crazy. But she's a good mama. But she's going to be way over.
Don't. Nope, you're not allowed to bite me.
And her baby's having...
She's over 5 pounds.
She's 5.5. Oh, we're a big girl.
Oh, don't. She might bite you.
No, she won't bite. She won't bite. It is a rabbit.
I'll go put her back in a minute.
Dad's talking to Will. All right.
All right,
next.
Go.
Yeah. But anyway, so they aren't necessarily, as Lena struggles with her, they aren't necessarily a bad rabbit, confirmation-wise and everything. It's just they're too big. And you don't want your bucks like that, but when you have a big doe, you put her in the breeding shed, as long as she's got everything else going for her. And so far, she's thrown really nice babies. Wish is her baby, and Wish is not going to be a big girl. So.
Oh, my goodness, you're a fat thing.
Oh. Dear, let's see what she's got now.
Oh, you're close
this,
to 4 pounds.
Oh, man. Oh, and look at, now this is a rabbit that may not make it because he's really gotten matted over the winter. Well, this is what happens. And he is just 4 pounds. This is a junior buck, though.
Look at his tattoo on that left ear.
Oh, I'll tell you in a minute. But, you know, if we get the mats off him, he might lose 1/2 pound. But he's over.
This is Midget.
Okay. He's over for a junior buck, isn't he? Do they have weight limits for the juniors?
Yeah.
So they can't be a senior
right.
weight. Ooh.
They're one of the breeds that you can't go up to the next category if they're too big.
Okay.
I'm gonna leave him home.
Yeah.
The way he is anyways.
He's really mad at
you. I know,
too.
Mom.
We'll have to go after him tonight.
All right, come on back.
You hate to do it too early in the season because then...
I don't want
to
get...
Because you take off a lot of their coat when you do that.
Don't
bite. And we during the summer and then fall and spring, she grooms them. But during the winter, she doesn't because she doesn't want them to lose hair when they need to stay warm. And,
Escalion.
Yeah. Here's another senior buck that we bought as a doe. And she went through...
He's underweight as usual.
She went through two shows as a... junior doe, and then when she turned into a senior doe, we discovered she was a he. Oops.
This is MO2 or Rascal, right? Yeah.
This is Blue.
No, that's Sarah's rabbit. Sarah's rabbit's Blue. His name's MO2.
No, Bluebell. That was its name.
I call him Rascal Bell.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Okay.
Or I go by attention.
You got to get rid of Matt's on this
one,
too.
No, that's Poop. He was in the cage underneath one of them.
Oh, and you were cleaning and he got...
So I got to groom him.
Ew.
What is his...
It
is
Poop.
Is he 3.5?
Okay. Minus the poop. He's 3 1/4.
Oh my gosh, rabbit.
Yeah, he's small.
And that, and I push food at him, he just won't eat. I'll take him, just to, as a sale buck.
Yeah. Because his pedigree is good. The problem that we had with him is we were going to take him to a show and sell him. We had him in the transfer cage, or the transport cages, carry cages. And one of the rabbits next to him got his ear.
It was Will.
Oh, it was Will. That's right.
Remember, he tipped Will.
Will tipped his cage over and bit his ear and split it. So now he can't be shown.
But he can be bred.
But he's got a nice pedigree for breeding. Mm-hmm. And he stays small, which if you've got a big brood dough, is not a bad way to go.
You got too much poop in your fur.
Yeah.
Ew.
Yeah, you was right. Yeah, buddy.
I'm glad he's your rabbit, Charlie Brown.
Oh, he's so sweet, though.
He's very sweet.
I wish I could keep this home, but I just don't have the
keys. Yeah. We'll take him and the other male in the house tonight and groom him up.
Yeah. And I'm going to... Oh, and he...
Is that everybody?
Yeah, that was everyone.
Okay.
Unless we want to weigh Buddy.
No, Buddy's...
I just want to see what he weighs.
All right. Buddy's our little Holland Lop.
Oh, he just wants to come out.
He's a former 4-H bunny.
He's dirty.
Everybody at the 4-H Club knows Buddy.
He's a 4-H celebrity.
He is. Because Buddy's dirty. Always after women.
He's 4 1/2. He's not bad.
Oh, he's not bad. Okay.
Probably about 1/2 pound over.
Well, yeah, for Buddy, that's good.
I can't find his spine. Where is your spine?
He had one when we put him in there last fall.
Oh. And let's not wait for Bree.
No.
Poor Bree.
Poor Bree. Bree has a weight problem. The goats are all doing well. I'll just kind of shoot them while I'm out here. Let me go outside and get a better
shot. Hi, ladies.
And sort of gentlemen. I think everybody is bred.
Especially Bella.
Yeah, especially Bella. Bella is due end of April. Mm-hmm. And then Haley will be due like a week or two after that, or if that. And then the older girls, the bigger girls, they're due like end of May.
Yeah.
First part of June. We had trouble getting, or I did, I didn't have trouble. He had trouble getting them bred this year. They were just a little tall for him.
Get down.
That was in a previous video. But I think we succeeded. I have not seen them come back into heat, and I think it's been past the time that they would.
Who's biting
so,
me?
Haley.
Haley. She wants attention. And hold his collar a minute for me.
Okay.
I want to check his... You got him?
Mm-hmm.
He says, I know what you're doing. Yeah, I still get my finger under there. I have to keep checking his horns so it's not going into his head. We have to time it to get them cut off so that they're cut off for fair and they haven't started growing back, because you can't have a horned alpine at fair. You can only have boar goats with horns.
No,
and
boar goats can't even
have
horns.
Oh, boar goats can?
Not
4-H. Oh, the mohair goats can.
Mohair, yeah. Angoras can.
Angoras, yeah.
You're not allowed to have horns.
I said the wrong, I meant angora.
Yeah.
I thought the boar goats could.
In national big shows they can. 4-H, no.
Oh, okay.
4-H,
I'll leave it to the little
Because they don't want
agricultural encyclopedia here.
They don't want kids to get hurt. So.
I know, but they let the Angora goats have them.
Well, Angora goats, it's a breed thing.
Yeah.
Boar goats, they're generally dehorned.
Okay, see, I'm not up on my meat goats. I'll admit it. I'm not up on my meat
Neither
goats.
Neither am I. I just know that one fun fact.
So, hopefully we're going to have...
She did.
She jumped over Bella.
Poor girl.
You're so funny, Gracie.
Come here, Gracie.
Hopefully Gracie, we'll have four... Sets of babies on the ground, or four groupings of babies.
At
two
least
and two.
Four.
Yeah, at least four. Because we got four does. I bred everybody. What the hey? I went crazy.
You thought we weren't going to breed. You said we weren't going to breed Bella this year, too.
I know. Bella had other ideas. She wanted to be
bred. She came in heat, so.
I'm thinking I'm going to sell Bella, so I did breed her.
I'm going to cry.
Well, I think I'm going to go to all alpines. It's just easier. Instead of the minis. We'll breed for minis, but. Although I'm really tempted to go back to full-size alpine as far as bucks, too. It's just easier to get them bred, although I do love having a tiny little buck on the place rather than a 200-pounder.
No, you're not going to eat it? Okay.
Yeah. All right.